Four out of five people sitting in the first class seats are not rich. They are smart. I'm always shocked how people think traveling is expensive or they think they can't afford to take a nice vacation. Worst, when I see people booking expensive flights or hotel stays. Well, the good thing is you are at the right place. This video is meant to show you strategies on how you can literally travel the world for free by mastering the secret. Yes, the secret. You ready for it? But before that, you do have to do me a favor and smack that like button and also subscribe if you're new here, because that is also free. Okay, so the secret is credit cards. Yes, you didn't expect that, did you? Credit card points. Now, if you aren't familiar with what credit card points are, it is a reward system that a credit card company uses to reward their customers. Basically, free money. Still think you can't afford to travel the world? In this video, we will debunk the myth that you need thousands of dollars to travel the world. It is my hope that I can share some of the strategies and tips that I've learned when it comes to saving money while traveling. So here are the four things that we will discuss throughout the video. Number one, how to earn thousands of dollars every year for free so you can travel all over the world. Number two, how to use and redeem the points. Number three, what are some of the must-follow rules in order to avoid getting trapped when implementing the strategies? And lastly, number four, start traveling the world for free. So let's get into it. Number one, how to earn thousands of dollars every year for free so you can use to travel all over the world. There are two ways to get these points. First, sign up for a new credit card that will give you a large sign-up bonus just for signing up with them. There are lots of credit cards out there, but one of my favorite is Chase Sapphire Preferred Card, which gives you 80,000 bonus points for opening a card. Now, there are some small requirements, which we will discuss shortly. But the second way you can get more points is by getting the right card for your usual daily expenses. I recommend the American Express Gold Card, which is what I personally have. The reason I love this American Express Gold, it gives you 4 points per every dollar spent on groceries and restaurants. And with an average American spending about $500 a month on groceries and food, that is $6,000 a year, which would be 24,000 points a year. That's awesome. Just by living your life, you could be accumulating a ton of points. That's why it's a big no-no to using a debit card for your daily purchases. Debit card equals zero rewards. On top of that, American Express Gold also gives you 60,000 bonus points just by signing up. There are many other cards that offer great bonuses like Chase Sapphire Reserve, which offers 50,000 bonus points, and American Express Platinum, which offers 75,000 bonus points. So now let's say you got that nice big sign-up bonus, or if you already have a travel credit card that has been accumulating points, how do you redeem and use them? Well, there are a few ways to redeem your points depending on the credit card, but most people end up exchanging them for free cash, which is 1 cent per 1 point. So that Chase Sapphire card of 80,000 bonus points times 1 cent equals to $800. What a great deal! Wrong! Big tip, exchanging your points for cash is one of the worst ways to utilize points. It would be like exchanging your Louis Vuitton bag for a Coach purse. Quite sad. Here's what I mean. While exchanging your points for cash gets you 1 cent per point, versus if you choose the right card and redeem these points for travel, it will give you a value of 2 cents to 10 cents back per point, which equals to $1,600 to $8,000. Yes, sometimes even more. You can literally get 10 times more value just by doing a little bit more of research like you are by watching this video and understanding how the system works. And look, I am guilty of it myself, so I get it. Because when you see that free cash, you might be inclined to take that $800 right away, but don't, because you could potentially end up getting a $3,000 vacation for your family instead. So So let's take a look at how you actually redeem them and get the most benefits of it. Generally speaking, the best way to get the most of your points is transfer them to an airline or hotel rewards program. A lot of these programs work together with a credit card company. So if you have 1,000 points with your credit card, it will transfer over exactly 1,000 points to a hotel or airline rewards program. So like we talked about, the example with the Chase Sapphire Preferred card, in order to get that 80,000 sign-up bonus points, their only requirement is you spend $4,000 in first 3 months. And if you do that, your points will be worth more than enough to spend 2 nights in Maldives at the Park Hyatt Hotel, normally a rate of $900 to $1,000 per night. Pretty awesome! Now you can't beat that. Moving on, number three, what are common traps to avoid when implementing these strategies? Seriously, a lot of people have fallen into the travel hacks, so it's important that you know which are the right credit cards to use so that you could take advantage of all the free vacations that you deserve. Trap number one, spending extra money just to get those bonus points. Please, please do not do this. Seriously, just do not. That is disastrous for your finances. Don't be fooled and let credit card companies win by getting tricked into spending more money than you intended to, just to get those points. Only apply if you know for sure you'll be spending that much money. Maybe you're moving and need new furniture, or you are a student and your semester is about to start and you will be spending money to get yourself set up for college. Then it's worth it. And trap number two, do not spend more money than you can afford. In excitement of building up points, don't blow up your wallet. Remember the Personal Finance 101, which is to live below your means and only spend on things that you need and not on unnecessary purchases just for points. My rule here is that spend as much as you can pay off at the end of each month without getting trapped into ridiculous interest fees. Trap number three, do not do any of the above we discuss in this video if you're about to get a loan on a house or on a car. This is because there is a very mild impact on your credit score each time you apply for a credit card. Expect that opening up a credit card might lower your score anywhere from 3 to 10 points temporarily. This is no big deal for someone dropping from 730 to 724, or for someone who isn't planning on buying a mortgage or a car loan in the next 12 months. It isn't going to make any difference to you. But if you are planning on buying a home, then stay away from applying any travel credit cards until your purchase is done. Trap number four, canceling the card. Honestly, it really depends on the card. If the card does not have an annual fee, I will always keep it, no matter what. There's nothing to lose by keeping it open, so you might as well just enjoy it as an extra credit card, even if you rarely use it. And on the card that do have fees, it really just depends if I get value from the card or not. If you're not going to be getting value from the card after the first year and it has an annual fee, close it. No point of paying for something that doesn't add value to you. And lastly, how to start traveling the world for free. Yes, traveling is fun. And when it's free, it's even more fun. Credit cards will offer some amazing rewards just for signing up with them. And the people who understand the art of how the system works can use this to their advantage by signing up for cards and meeting minimum requirements. Many people are concerned that signing up for new credit cards will hurt your credit score. This may be true if you have a lot of credit card debt already. But if you're relatively debt-free and have a good credit, applying for a few new cards won't hurt as long as you don't go crazy and max them out. As you see, these free rewards really start adding up quick. Start small, get one credit card bonus at a time, slowly scale up as you get more comfortable with it, and pretty soon you'll be traveling the world, getting the free perks on everything. So hope this video brought you some awareness on how you can go and make the most use of the secret, credit cards. After all, they're not as evil as people make them seem. If it helped, please be sure to give it a like and subscribe for more videos every Tuesdays and Fridays. I will see you all soon.